you apply for that first job, you know, where you get to use all this new knowledge that you've gained, you know, that's going to be another uncomfortable zone in some ways, because you're going to be stepping into a new environment and you're going to be expected to learn these skills and talents that you've gained here. And that's in the real world, and that's going to be frightening and scary and uncomfortable at times, but it will be required for you to achieve what you want to achieve. So important. We cannot become what we need by remaining what we are. You may have heard of the book by Marshall Goldsmith called What Got You Here Won't Get You There. It's been around for probably 20 years. And so the point of the book is as we grow and develop in our careers particularly, there are habits and ways of being and ways of interacting that work for us for a while. But once we get out there in the world and we start wanting to play a bigger game, or we get the opportunity to play a bigger game, whatever that is, then we need to examine those ways of being and ways of relating and thought patterns and habits that may not serve us in this bigger game that we want to play. So important. That's part of assessing on a regular basis. Have I been hanging out in this comfort zone a little too long? And what might I need to do to get myself out of that comfort zone, even if it feels a little uncomfortable? And that takes us to this, number 9 of 10. If you want it bad enough, trust. Take a gulp and leap. So important. When I got connected to my purpose about 10 years ago, it took me a couple of years to finally leave corporate life, resign from my role as president and chief growth officer of a company headquartered in Chicago, and to leave without a real plan, which is very unlike me. And I began to feel like I was walking up to the edge of a cliff. And every few days I'd walk up there and I'd think, am I ready? Am I ready? Am I ready to resign? Am I ready? You know, and I finally set a date. I was going to resign at the end of March after our annual conference, because that was a good time to resign, because other people had done that in our company. And and one day I showed up at the office in Chicago. It was on February 21st. I'll never forget this. And I realized, this is the day. This is the day I have to do this. And I didn't have my plan ready, because I was giving myself another month to figure that out and like actually take the leap and resign. But I did it. And I felt like I had just jumped off a cliff. What I realized in that moment is that there were safety nets there that were gonna catch me. I didn't know what they were, but I could see them. And that's what gave me the courage to finally do it. So I resigned on February 21st. We agreed that we weren't gonna tell anybody until after the conference in March. So we kept it top secret. I agreed to stay on for another 3 months after that while we found my successor. We did that successfully. And then my successor asked me and our CEO if I would stay on for another 3 months to run the business while he learned the business. And I knew I could work well with him. That wouldn't have worked in every situation, but I just knew him and knew that would work well, and it did. So it was a gradual transition out. And then I took some time off. I gave myself some space that I needed to really get connected to this work that I wanted to do. So all of that happened in 2012. And by the end of September of 2012, it took from February to the end of September to completely cut the cord and be free from corporate life. And I gave myself 6 months to figure out a plan. And within just a short period of time, I knew. On November 15th that year, I signed up for my coaching training, started that in January, and officially started my business in January of 2013. So I just say all that because it was that connecting to purpose 2 years before all of that that led me here, and I've never looked back, ever, because I love the work that I get to do, and I love helping others grow and realize their full potential. So if I hadn't taken that leap, I wouldn't be standing here today.
Have faith, take a leap. You'll either unfold your wings and learn to fly, or you'll learn to swim. Trust yourself and jump in with all you have. Once you know what you want and the picture is clear, go after it and make it happen. That's going to require stepping out of comfort zones. It's going to require having some faith, but it's worth building. I promise. And then last is to find your leadership legacy. And so often when I bring up this topic of legacy or leadership, people say, well, you know, I'm too young for that. You know, that's what people in their 70s and 80s and 90s do, right? Think about their legacy. Well, I believe that the more we consider this now, in our 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, the more likely it is we're going to leave the legacy that we want to leave. And so it's a matter of asking the questions, how do you want to be remembered when it's all over, when you exit your career, when you decide to retire, when you're no longer here, you know, how do you want to be remembered? And we're leaving little legacies along the way in every stage of our life, right? I think about my first job out of college. I taught elementary school for 4 years. I left a legacy with those students, right? I think about my second job. I left a legacy in some way. When I'm coaching clients that are making career transitions, and they've said, what I'm doing anymore isn't working for me, I want something else, and they begin to figure out what that is, and they start moving in that direction, that's when I ask the question, how do you want to be remembered when you leave this thing behind, this old job behind? How do you want to be remembered? Did you leave the job in a better place? Did you form some enduring relationships? Did you help someone along the way? What are those things that you're going to want to be remembered for, and the things that you're going to want to remember about this part of your career and this part of your life? We leave little legacies along the way, every step of the way, and I think it's incredibly important to be mindful of that, because the more we're aware of this, the more intention we can have about that. I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. And that is part of your legacy every single day in how you show up with people, personally and professionally. So that wraps us up. There's a summary, and there are some of the book recommendations. We'll share this with you. Any closing comments or questions? What will you take away from this? What was useful or valuable about this for you today? Big or small?
Yeah. And thank you to Ms.